A 26-year-old male patient is brought into the emergency department for difficulty breathing, urticaria, and periorbital edema after eating shrimp. You notice that the patient is hoarse and has respiratory stridor. His skin is flushed. You take his vital signs and note the following. Heart rate equals 135 beats per minute. Blood pressure equals 90 over 50 millimeters of mercury. Respiratory rate equals 30 per minute with exertion. Oxygen saturation equals 94%. Question 1. What is your diagnosis of the patient? A. Anaphylaxis. B. Acute asthma. C. Acute angioedema. D. Panic attack. Correct answer. A. Anaphylaxis. Anaphylaxis can be diagnosed if one of the following criteria is fulfilled. 1. Acute onset of the symptoms that occur within minutes to several hours and involves the skin and mucosal tissue, hives, itch, flush, swollen lips, tongue, or uvula, plus either respiratory compromise or reduction of blood pressure associated with end organ dysfunction,
syncope,
incontinence, etc. 2. An exposure to a known allergen with two or more of the following symptoms: skin and or mucosal tissue involvement, hives, itch, flush, swollen lips, tongue, or uvula, respiratory compromise, stridor, dyspnea, wheezing, etc., reduction of blood pressure, and persistent gastrointestinal signs and symptoms, vomiting or crampy abdominal pain. 3. Reduction of systolic blood pressure of less than 90 millimeters of mercury, or a 30% decrease from the baseline blood pressure after exposure to a known allergen. He suddenly loses consciousness and becomes unresponsive. You check for a pulse and note that it is rapid and thready. He is not breathing. Question 2. What is your first course of action? A. Give 2 rescue breaths. B. Attach the patient to a defibrillator. C. Perform high-quality CPR. D. Shout for help and activate the emergency response team. Correct answer? D. Shout for help and activate the emergency response team. The patient has experienced a respiratory arrest and needs urgent advanced life support, ALS. Activating the emergency response team brings in the additional help you need for resuscitation. It also sends in the crash cart that contains vital pharmacologic therapies, advanced airway instruments, and most importantly, a defibrillator. You open the airway as the ACLS team arrives. Question 3. The best course of action is to A. Begin high-quality CPR. B. Begin ventilations with the bag mask device. C. Observe the patient. D. Take vital signs. Correct answer, B. Begin ventilations with the bag mask device. The man is in respiratory arrest, and immediate intervention must begin to provide ventilations. Question 4. The correct rate of ventilation for this patient is A. 1 breath every 2 seconds. B. 2 breaths every 3 seconds. C. 1 breath every 6 seconds. D. 2 breaths every 6 seconds. Correct answer, C. 1 breath every 6 seconds. In a respiratory arrest situation, the rescuer should ventilate once every 6 seconds, 10 breaths per minute. Question 5. Each breath should be given over A. 1 second, B. 2 seconds, C. 3 seconds, D, 4 seconds. Correct answer, A, 1 second. Each breath should be given over 1 second, so you see visible chest rise with each breath. The patient is connected to a biphasic defibrillator and an intravenous line is inserted in the dorsal vein of the right hand. Another team member reports there is not a pulse. You monitor the ECG tracing. Question 6. What is your interpretation of the ECG finding? A. Torsade de pointe.
B. Paroxysmal supraventricular tachycardia.
C. Ventricular fibrillation. D. Ventricular tachycardia. Correct answer, D. Ventricular tachycardia. Ventricular tachycardia is characterized by fast and regular rhythm, with absent P waves and a wide QRS complex. Question 7. What is your next course of action? A. Defibrillate. B. Continue with high-quality CPR for 2 minutes and epinephrine 1 mg intravenously every 3 to 5 minutes. C. Synchronized cardioversion. D. Vasopressin 40 units intravenous bolus. Correct answer, A. Defibrillate. Once pulseless ventricular tachycardia is diagnosed, the immediate response is defibrillation. After the previous intervention, you check for the rhythm and see the following ECG tracing. Question 8. Given the patient's situation, the most important treatment is A. Administer antihistamines. B. Cardioversion. C. Aggressive fluid resuscitation. D. Establish advanced airway. Correct answer, D. Establish advanced airway. The presence of hoarseness and stridor may indicate an inflamed epiglottis, and an endotracheal tube or other advanced airway may be difficult to insert. Treatments for anaphylaxis can be administered once ROSC has been achieved. A surgical airway was inserted via tracheostomy. High-quality CPR was continued for another 3 cycles. Epinephrine 1 mg was given intravenously. You check the rhythm and see the following. Question 9. What is the interpretation of the ECG findings? A. Normal sinus rhythm. B. Sinus bradycardia. C. Idioventricular rhythm. D. Third degree AV block. Correct answer, B. Sinus bradycardia. The presence of a P wave and normal QRS complex indicate a sinus rhythm. A heart rate of 42 beats per minute indicates a sinus bradycardia. The following vital signs are recorded. Heart rate equals 42 beats per minute. Blood pressure equals 80 over 50 millimeters of mercury. Respiratory rate
equals 12 breaths per minute.
Temperature equals 36.1 degrees Celsius. Oxygen saturation equals 95%. The patient is unconscious. Question 10. What is your next course of action? A. Give antihistamines and beta blockers. B. Bolus intravenous administration of 1 liter normal saline solution.
C. Continue high-quality CPR for 2 minutes, followed by epinephrine 1 mg IV every 3 to 5 minutes. D. Optimize ventilation and oxygenation. Correct answer, D. Optimize ventilation and oxygenation. You have achieved ROSC, and the first step is to optimize ventilation and oxygenation. This can be achieved by titrating ventilation to target end-tidal carbon dioxide, PETCO2, to 35 to 40 millimeters of mercury and an oxygen saturation of more than or equal to 92 to 98%. The patient is being prepared for transport to the intensive care unit. You again record the patient's vital signs and get the following. Heart rate equals 62 beats per minute. Blood pressure equals 90 over 60 millimeters of mercury. Respiratory rate equals 12 per minute mechanical ventilator assisted. Temperature equals 36.1 degrees Celsius. Oxygen saturation equals 100%. The patient is still unconscious. Question 11. What is your next consideration for this patient? A. Fibrinolysis. B. Percutaneous coronary intervention. C. Cardiac pacing. D. Targeted temperature management. Correct answer, D. Targeted temperature management. Current guidelines recommend the use of targeted temperature management for comatose adult patients. Temperatures should be maintained between 32 degrees Celsius and 36 degrees Celsius.